Feminist Creativas presents a word for every generation that knows no fashion.
Greetings. I hope and trust I find you well, my brothers and sisters. We are discussing a touchy devotional this morning. Have you ever dealt with someone who is ungrateful? Done a good thing for someone who is thankless? If ever, then this is your devotional. It is titled Mission to the Ungrateful. I repeat, Mission to the Ungrateful. Come with me to the book of 1 Samuel. We are at chapter 23. We begin reading at verse 9 and we'll go all the way to verse number 12. The Bible then says, "When David learned that Saul was plotting evil against him, he said to Abiathar the priest, 'Bring the ephod.' Then he said, 'Lord God of Israel, your servant has heard that Saul intends to come to Keilah and destroy the town because of me. Will the citizens of Keilah hand me over to him? Will Saul come down as your servant has heard? Lord God of Israel, please tell your servant.' The Lord answered, 'He will come down.'" Verse number 12, "Then David asked, 'Will the citizens of Keilah hand me and my men over to Saul?' 'They will,' the Lord responded." May the good Lord bless the reading of his word as we pray. Let us pray. Kind and gracious Father, in the heavens above, thank you, dear Lord, for the privilege of considering thy word. For we are reminded, when good is done, it does not correspond to loyalty. When good is done, it does not correspond to gratitude. And oh, Father, as we learn of the story of David and the citizens of Keilah, how I pray we are different towards the son of David and become grateful for what he has done. This is our prayer of faith. In Jesus' name we pray and we ask, amen. Amen. My dear friends, I just want to raise, as our custom is, 5 points. And without much ado, notice who are these citizens of Keilah. They are the children of Judah. They are on the outskirts of the perimeter of the family of Judah. They are closer to the Philistines than David was because they were in around a cave close to Hebron thereabout. And as they are in hiding from Saul with these 600 men or so, word comes that Saul, listen, David, the Philistines have attacked the citizens of Keilah. And on point number one, David inquires of the Lord, "Should I go after these Philistines who have brought about abject poverty upon the citizens of Keilah? For they had besieged them just at the time of harvest, taken off their entire harvest and their livestock, and driven off to the Philistine territory. Now David and his 600 men pursue these Philistines to rescue the citizens of Keilah." May I talk to someone and say, where you come from, you also have people that are born into your tribe, people that are born into your family. If it is in your power to do so, go out and assist. Do not sit and stay in your cave and safety while those of your motherland are suffering. Do something towards their sustenance. Do something towards their longevity. Go out and assist. David did this, and I want to challenge you on this. If it is in your power, go out and assist. And David, as he's there, I believe he talks to the prophet that he had at the time, because by then the ephod had not come through with Abiathar. And he inquires, "Should we go out and attack the Philistines?" And the Lord says, "Go." And the gentleman that he's with, the army, they inquire, "David, we are in a safe zone. When we go out into that particular town of Keilah, we become sitting ducks for Saul to attack us, because we might fall against the Philistines ahead of us. We may take on arrows from Saul behind us. You may want to rethink this." And David calls upon the prophet and inquires for the second time, "If we go, will we succeed?" And the Lord says, "Go." This is how they set off on this mission to an ungrateful people. Having arrived, what did David do? He recovered their goods. He recovered their livestock and returned everything into the city of Keilah. While he's in the city of Keilah, Saul sent out a call, a rally call, for people to come out and go to war against the Philistines who had attacked Keilah. But Saul, even though he is going out on this mission, David knew better. Saul is headed towards Keilah in order to catch David while he's walled up in the city of Keilah and annihilate him, kill him, destroy him. This is what now brings us into our passage of the day. Now David inquires of the Lord as he has heard that Saul is en route to Keilah in order to attack him. And he inquires, Lord, should I remain here? Will these people hand me over? And the Lord says, in spite of the good you have done for them, they shall hand you over to Saul. This is something that no one would want to hear. When we have done good by people, we expect them to be loyal to us and not betrayers. We expect them to be loyal to us and not snitches. And as you are going into the workplace, may I tell you this, those you have done good for are the ones who are going to set the peg into your back. It is biblical. It is already written. Doing good by someone at point number three does not breed loyalty in them. Didn't Christ come all the way from heaven, forsook everything so that we could be served? And who crucified him? Those who were objects of salvation. As you go into the workspace, those you are going to do good by, they are not going to become loyal for long. When it is expedient, they will hand you over. They will get rid of you. They will protect and preserve their own lives over yours. This is a mission to the ungratefuls, but be that as it may, we still go and we still do the good thing because we are David's. We are the sons of David. It is in our nature to do that which is good. To do that which is good. And at point number four, notice that some people must be left behind, not because of their ingratitude, not in retaliation to their ingratitude, but for their own good. As David inquires, he says, when I stay here, I gather Saul is going to come to this place and destroy the city under the pretext of fighting the Philistines. When he is actually here to fight me, should I then leave these people? And the Lord says, if you remain in Keilah, these people will die. Some people need to be done a favor of leaving them. It is not always a bad thing to leave some people. Do not linger in the company of the ungratefuls. Do them a favor and move out of their lives. Do them good and move out of their lives. Do not linger. If you linger long enough, they'll disappoint you. If you linger long enough, they will sell you off. If you linger long enough, they'll kill you for doing that which is good. And at point number five, Saul, having heard that David is in Keilah, he says, the Lord has answered my prayer. The Lord has set him in that walled city so that I can find him and deal with this errant boy and deal with this rebel. And many of us have uttered hallelujahs and amens to prayers that have not been answered by God. We have said, the Lord has brought the prey right into my hand, and yet the Lord has not done so. We have a propensity and a leaning towards answering our own prayers. You need not do any wrong, O child of God, in order to find soul celebrating. Even when you are doing the right, you will still become a target for doing the right things. While he's out there saving Keilah, Saul finds reason to say, now it's time to deal with him. Do not tire, O Galatians, to do that which is right, to do that which is good. Do it for the ungratefuls, and while you're at it, know this for a fact. Saul is out to get you. You are a marked man. You are a marked lady, but be that as it may, go on missions for God and do the best that you can for your relatives, for your loved ones, for your neighbors, and even for your enemies. By the way, this was something that should have been done by Saul. Saul was the one who was supposed to come to the rescue of the citizens of Keilah. But David instead goes to rescue them. Even when you are doing people a favor, they will find reason to fight you and find reason to take you out. Be that as it may the good Lord bless you. May he prosper you. May he give you peace that surpasseth all understanding and assays your enemies. Blessings and peace.